Tommy, Saturday night, Daniel Dubois got beat off Joe Joyce. I think me and you picked Daniel Dubois to win this
yes,
one.
Yes, I did.
Hold our hands up. Joe Joyce did a fantastic job on him, didn't he?
Yes, yes.
You know, boxed perfect tactics and won the fight. Give me your thoughts on the fight, Tommy.
Right, I'll tell you this straight. I did pick the voice of it. I thought that you could have it stay, but I've got to say this. For John Joyce, what did he do? He beat him with the jab. What he done, the first seconds I saw him box, he reminded me of old Fred Pickering. Get to the centre of the ring and stick that jab out. Give it all you've got. Because the man who usually lands first with the jab usually wins the fight. That's what Fred always used to say. And Joyce dictated that fight with that jab, didn't he? So no matter what the boys tried, and he did land some good punches, he dictated that fight with the jab. And he kept that jab going on the injuries he caused on the boys, didn't he? There's no getting away from it.
The finish, Tom, the eye was getting worse and worse as the fight went on.
Look,
you could see that Dubois was getting a little bit deflated in the corner.
He
was juicing up. You know, you could see the writing was a bit on the wall earlier on than the stoppage.
You could. To be honest, a lot of people say, Quest, what you want to look at is this. That lad couldn't see through that eye. He's 22 years of age. Okay, anybody can make statements like that. But what I'm saying to you is this. That lad, he realised he was in a fight he couldn't win. Right? Now, he's had to have major surgery on that eye. Now, what I'm saying to you, he can come again. He'll need to fight again. I've said there's a lot of brave people in the crowd, a lot of brave seconds, a lot of brave referees. I think personally that it's how he comes back from this. If he can come back mentally strong after this. Because don't you worry, Joyce was up for that. And he had a game plan and he stayed to that game plan. And it was the jab that picked the lock. Because the boys could not get away from that jab. I mean, a lot of people are levelling criticism at Dubois. It was like this. He couldn't get the way out of that jab. He was badly marked up. He lives to fight another day. Give him a chance to fight another day. I mean, you don't know what goes into a man's mind, do you? And if he couldn't see through that eye, and he needed two eyes to fight the old guys. Because one was no good.
I believe the eye socket was broke as well, Tom, and there was nerve
damage.
That's
what I'm talking about. You don't know.
Some pain must have been going on there as well.
I mean, this is what I said about Kell Brook. He had his eye socket broke twice, hasn't he? With Golovkin and Errol Spence. Now, I mean, okay, everybody's different. I remember John Smith fighting Pagnani, and it was like a reed in the wind with Pagnani's attack. And Pat Dwyer jumped in the ring, and the referee went to stop, and there was John Smith trying to throw him away to get back at Pagnani. I mean, that will always stick in my mind, but what I'm saying to you, we don't know what pain Joyce was going with. What pain Dubois was going through with that eye, and we won't know how it affects him until he gets back in the ring again, will we?
No. There is a lot of brave people. Tommy, you're right, in the crowds, a lot of brave people
behind
computer screens too. It is how he comes back from it.
You see, this is what I'm saying. Ricky went and come back from Floyd Churchill, come back from that tragedy with Bradley Stone. I've seen great lads great prospects. They suffered a defeat. And it's just the whole stuffing's been knocked out of them. They've never been the same. And I've seen other people get a right thinking and come back. That's not going to happen again. It's a very thing. There's no two men the same. I mean, all you've got to do is this. You look at Meldrick Taylor. He'd have got the decision over Chavez and he was stopped with seconds to go. Meldrick Taylor won a world title after again. But he was never the same fellow, was he? Now, why? I'll tell you for why. Mentally, it was a mental problem. It was just, he thought the whole world was against him. Even in a fight like that, a momentous fight like that, and that happens. You know, it's unbelievable. It's just the end of the world for you, isn't it?
Let's look at the fight tactically, Tom. We know what Joe Joyce did good to win the fight, and he used his jab and he took centre of the ring. What did Dubois not do, and what does he need to work on to sort of to make this comeback that if he's capable of doing
know,
it?
He didn't know how to get out over that jab, did he? He didn't know how to get out the road of that jab. I mean, what I'm saying was he had movements and different things, you know, the bobbing, weaving and rolling underneath it. You've heard me say this. I'm not making excuses because I took your voice, but I'm a big believer in the rounds under your belt. I mean, I said that with Richie having the rounds under his belt when he fought Paul Lloyd, and I'm a big believer in it.
And he's been knocking over these fellas.
I'll tell you straight, he's a big believer in it. It's like the same with Tyson Fury. A lot of people won't go the distance with Tyson Fury because he's needed the rounds under his belt. Those rounds under your belt, they can be a chapter in a book when you come up to the plate. I mean, this is why a journeyman can make a damn good trainer, because he's been with every aspect, hasn't he? The southpaws, he's been with them all, the big hitters, and he needs to know how to look after himself. So he can box again next week or the week after. Look at Curtis Gargano. Look at some of the people he's been in with.
Yeah.
You know, you learn a lot of people like that. Yeah, you learn a lot of people like that. Don't you worry.
Definitely. Tell me, how do you go with Daniel Dubois from there? How do you rebuild, in your opinion, if you was coaching him?
If I was coaching him, the first thing I'd do was to, and I'm in the gym and I'd be talking to him, trying to bring his confidence back on different things like that. Be like a bad day at the office. You've got to get into a person's mind and his personality. And then if he was coming back, what I would do, look, Peter Fury, you have a look at the people he had Chamberlain, didn't he, working out with them? You know, with Tyson Fury and those, didn't he?
Yeah.
The American.
Yeah.
Yeah. Get somebody like that over. Get somebody like that over to move around with him, to show him the different smarts of the game and things like that. You know, things like that you need. You see, it was the same with Frank Bruno. Frank Bruno, they said he couldn't take it, but he could take a punch. He didn't know how to fiddle his way out. You see, some of these people, not everybody's going to be a pushover. You can be a world beater and somebody can stun you. Once you're stunned and your speed has gone to get you out of it, if you've got you out of trouble in the past, for those split seconds, you're gone. If you can't fiddle yourself, I don't know how to clinch and how to hold and tie a man up. And you've got to learn these things in the gym, how to tie them up so it becomes instinct from the get-go. It's just like skipping. You tell somebody how to skip, you can't, but you show them. And all of a sudden, they're like two people with two left legs. And all of a sudden, they get the rhythm. And it's the same with tying up and things like that. You know, it's... He just couldn't get... He didn't know how to cut the ring off sufficiently against Joe Joyce.
That's a fair point. I think that was one of the things, Tommy cutting the ring off, he was just coming forward, and his variety of shots as well.
I believe there's a fight coming up shortly, and the same thing can happen again with the jab.
We'll talk about that one as well, Tommy. But you know, with Dubois, you're right there. If you're not learning it in the fights, then it's the sparring is all about getting sparring partners who are better than you, isn't it? Or the ones who give you trouble every time.
It's no use sort of dominating sparring.
So do you think he maybe has not been getting that sort of sparring, or would you suggest that if he is, he's going to have to start upping it now and really being uncomfortable in the gym as well?
I don't know, I'm not telling a trainer a job, but like what I've seen happen, you've had some good fighters that's been really good. Now, I know your boy would beat them if they were boxing now. Say your prospect would beat them if they were boxing now. But what would you do? You'd get two or three of those lads in the gym and you wouldn't put them sparring all the time. You'd around, and you'd swap them over. So if the boy's got to think all the time, and those fellas are giving him all the, giving him problems when the sparring he's going to get over. You wouldn't get him go four rounds straight up. You'd have a round with one, a round with another, a round with the other, and then you'd interchange them, you see. So the boy's thinking all the time, and he's improving all the time, he's learning all the time. But I think that if he got, say, one of the heavyweights, or like an old gatekeeper or something like that, to do some sparring with him and show him a few of the old tricks, I think he could come again. No problem. I think a lot of it's mentally, and he's got to be taught, spoken to. Yeah. Open the way up to him, because he just couldn't get back out of the Joyce. Joyce had his plan and he kept to his plan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think Joyce has definitely made a few fans overall with his attitude and
Now, you've got to look at it this way. He's won a fight, right? Now, let's hope he gets a reward for it. Now, let's hope one thing. He's older than Tyson Fury and Anthony Joshua. For hell's sake, let the lad earn a good purse, have a defining fight. This was the defining fight. Let him earn some damn good money for that win. And there's no getting away from it. You've got Callum Smith now. He's going against the Sack Deck. Callum has always been getting ready for Callum Smith. He's known all along. Callum's had a month's notice. These sort of things. Either, don't you worry, he should have called Callum Smith if he wanted to fight him 2 years ago when Callum won that series. You know, these sort of things. The same thing's happening. You've got a stop and go start. I know this with this virus going on, but it hasn't been easy, has it?
What would you like to see Joe Joyce do next? He talked about him fighting Usyk, like a rematch of the amateur fight that he had.
Well, I'll just tell you one thing. I think that would be a good bout. I think Joe Joyce, Usyk, but I think Joyce would be a little bit... You know how I feel about the weight difference with Usyk. He is his weight, but I'm a great cruiserweight. But it's a different thing when you move up a weight. I mean, and there's one thing about it, if he gets a good game plan, Joyce, he will stick to that game plan. There's one thing that trainer knows with Joe Joyce, that Joyce will do as he told, he'll listen. And that's a hell of a thing. And when you look at his pedigree and he's still willing to learn, that shows that it can be a danger.
It's definitely opened up the heavyweight division a bit, hasn't it, Tommy?
That, oh, that, well, yeah.
you know, we've Dubois, we liked him for all the skills that he had and the way he went about it, and we've, you know, not lost that. Hopefully he can come back as well. So
yeah,
it's certainly hotting up that heavyweight division.
Oh, there's no getting away from it.